अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप एवरीवन इज़ फाइन एंड सेफ एट होम। आई एम योर साइंस टीचर मिस उज़मा। आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू पेज नंबर 107, 108 एंड 109 ऑफ चैप्टर फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंज। योर प्रीवियस टॉपिक इज़ अबाउट फिजिकल चेंज इन विच आर सब्सटेंस चेंजेस फ्रॉम अ सॉलिड टू अ लिक्विड और अ लिक्विड टू अ गैस और बैक अगेन। स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड, इफ़ यू पुट सम वाटर इन द फ्रीजर it will turn into ice. On the other hand, at high temperature, ice will melt and will turn into water. The process of freezing and melting of ice and turning into water is called reversible process. Similarly, this whole process can be turned into reversible process again and again. However, some reactions are also reversible. One of the best known reversible reaction occurs when copper sulfate crystals are heated. You can see blue copper sulfate crystals in this picture, and the formula is CuSO4.5H2O. This means that 5 molecules of water are attached with copper sulfate. This is also called hydrated copper sulfate. Look at this picture. When we heat these crystals of copper sulfate, water will remove in the form of steam. You have also observed that on heating, crystals of copper sulfate have been converted into white powder form of copper sulfate. This reaction can be reversed by adding water in it. Means if we add few drops of water in anhydrous copper sulfate, blue crystals of copper sulfate will reform. This means that the reaction is reversible. Let's understand the second example of reversible reaction. It is also a lab activity in which we heat the nitrogen dioxide gas. Look at the picture. Nitrogen dioxide gas is in closed flask. It is in brown color and its formula is NO2. N stands for nitrogen and O stands for oxygen. If we heat the nitrogen dioxide gas, it will convert into nitric oxide and oxygen gas. But how we come to know this? When the nitrogen dioxide gas is heated in closed flask, its color becomes lighter and lighter until at 620 degrees Celsius, the gas is totally colorless because it has broken down into nitric oxide and oxygen, both of which are colorless gases. After some time, when flask is cold, we see the flask is again filled with a brown gas. Why this happens? Because nitric oxide and oxygen combine in flask and reform nitrogen dioxide gas. Reversible reactions. These are the reactions which move back. It means any reaction which move back is a reversible reaction. Physical changes are also reversible. These reactions can move either direction depending upon the conditions. Means these reactions can move in both directions, forward and backward as well. Double head arrow symbol is used in these reactions. Means when we write word equation or symbolic reaction, we use double head arrow, which indicates a reaction is reversible. Students, I hope you have well understood about physical change. Next topic which we are going to start is chemical change. In a chemical change, one or more new substances are formed. Chemical change do not reverse easily. We have lot of examples around us, like rust on iron. When any iron object is left in an open area, it will turn into rust. Can the rust turn back into iron? The answer is definitely no, because a chemical change has done in it, which cannot reverse. Like this, the cooked egg cannot turn back into raw egg because the chemicals that make up the egg have changed by cooking to make new substances. In chemical reactions, some new substances are formed. A substance which makes new substance is called reactant. Means a substance that takes part in and undergoes a change during a reaction is a reactant. it makes new substance. New substance which is formed when chemical reaction takes place is called product. The chemical reaction is a chemical change actually, and it is not easy to reverse this process. Let's understand the process of making brick in which a chemical change takes place. Students, I will explain this process of making brick in steps so that you understand easily. The reactants or ingredients which are required for this process are sand, wet clay, and coal dust. Coal dust is a fine powder form of coal which is made by crushing or grinding of coal. You can see the picture of coal dust here. Step number one. These reactants or ingredients are mixed and made into brick shape as they are soft and can be cut or molded easily. Step number two. They are left to dry for 3 days. Step number three. They are baked in an oven at 1200 degrees Celsius, which is very high temperature. Step number four. They are left to cool and hard bricks are formed. Is it possible to turn the brick back into its original ingredients after it has been baked? No, not at all, because a chemical change has been done in it. Hence, this whole process is irreversible. Here we have two life processes, photosynthesis and respiration. In these two processes, chemical change take place and they are also called chemical reactions. Photosynthesis. Plants make their food, glucose, with the help of carbon dioxide gas and water. They take in sunlight energy to proceed the reaction. Means they require sunlight energy to carry on the reaction. Respiration. Food particles are broken down with the help of oxygen gas. As a result, energy is released. During respiration and photosynthesis, new substances are formed. Let's see another example of chemical reaction between iron and sulfur. You can see iron dust called iron filing and sulfur in powdered form in this picture. Symbol of iron is Fe and symbol of sulfur is S. Both iron and sulfur are elements. Recall your memory, students. You have already learned what are elements. A substance that cannot be converted into other simpler substances called element. For example, sulfur, ferric, oxygen, nitrogen. S stands for sulfur, Fe stands for iron, O stands for oxygen, and N stands for nitrogen. These are all elements. Look at this picture. You can see a mixture of iron filing and sulfur. What is a mixture? When two or more substances are mixed in such a way that no chemical reaction occurs, is called a mixture. The mixing components retain their individual properties and can separate easily. For example, sand and water, sugar and salt. Look at this picture. There is a mixture of iron filing and powdered sulfur. No chemical reaction is going on, and you can easily separate these two in a very simple way. You just rotate a magnet inside the mixture. Iron filings, being magnetic in nature, will stick to the magnet, and only powdered sulfur is left behind. Can you tell what type of change is it? Yes, it is a physical change. Now what happens when we gently start heating this mixture of iron filings and sulfur? The yellow sulfur seems to be disappeared and dark blackish gray compound called iron sulfide is formed. It is impossible to separate iron filing from iron sulfide through magnet because a chemical change has taken place and new compound, that is iron sulfide, is formed. Now what is compound? When two or more elements combine chemically in a fixed ratio known as compound. For example, FeS iron sulfide, NaCl sodium chloride, CuSO4 copper sulfate. Here you can see chemical reaction and word equation for this reaction between iron filing and powder sulfur. Iron plus sulfur goes to iron sulfide. Fe plus S goes to FeS. In these reactions, single head arrow is used, which shows a chemical reaction is unidirectional and it only goes forward. Let's understand what actually happens during chemical reaction. In a chemical reaction, four things happen. I will explain each point one by one. A new substance is produced, which usually looks quite different from the substance you started with. As you have learned before, in chemical reaction between iron and sulfur, a new product, iron sulfide, is formed, which is very much different from its reactants that are iron and sulfur. Energy is given out or taken in during the reaction. You have learned the process of respiration, in which energy is given out, and photosynthesis, in which energy is taken in. The change may be impossible to reverse. They are non-reversible. Right, it is impossible to reverse the chemical change. We have seen this in the process of making bricks. It is impossible to turn the bricks back into their ingredients. Although the atoms of each element combine in different ways, the same atoms that were there at the start are there at the end of the reaction. Because of this, the total mass stays the same. Total mass of the substance you have before the reaction must equal the total mass of the substance you have at the end. It means that the total mass of all the substances taking part in the reaction remain the same. Also, the number of atoms in the reaction remain the same. Look at the reaction here. Zinc carbonate, ZnCO3, is a reactant, gives two compounds, carbon dioxide CO2 and zinc oxide ZnO. At the reactant end, there is one atom of zinc, one atom of carbon and are three atoms of oxygen. And at the product end, there is also one atom of zinc, one atom of carbon and are three atoms of oxygen. This shows the number of atoms stay same at both ends. Students, we have two types of chemical reactions here: exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. A reaction which gives out heat energy is called exothermic reaction. Exo means release and thermo means heat. Respiration is one of the examples of exothermic reaction, in which energy is released in the form of heat. Another example of this reaction is a reaction between iron and sulfur. Although we heat iron and sulfur to start up the reaction, but it gives out heat once it gets going. A reaction which takes in heat energy is called endothermic reaction. Endo means within and thermo means heat. Example of endothermic reactions are photosynthesis and cooking food. About endothermic reactions, you will learn in detail in next lecture. Here you can see related questions from your exercise book, page number 116. Question number 8. Explain the following terms and give three examples of each: element, compound, mixture, physical change, chemical change. Students, these terms have been explained in lecture also. Element, a substance which cannot be converted into other simpler substances called an element. For example, sulfur, iron, oxygen, nitrogen. Compound, when two or more elements combine chemically in a fixed ratio, a compound is formed. Examples, iron sulfide, sodium chloride, copper sulfate. Mixture, when two or more substances mixed in such a way that no chemical reaction occurs, is called a mixture. The mixing components retain their individual properties and can be separated easily. Example, sand and salt, iron filing and sulfur, sugar and salt. Physical change, a change in which materials alter without changing its chemical makeup, is called physical change. The particles in the material do not change. Physical changes are reversible. Examples: melting, freezing, boiling. Chemical change. Chemical changes take place in chemical reactions in which new compounds are formed. Chemical changes are irreversible. Examples: photosynthesis, formation of iron sulfide, rusting of iron. Question number 9. What four things happen during a chemical change or chemical reaction? I have explained all the points. You can also see page number 108 of your book. Question number 10. Give three examples of chemical change. I have discussed some examples of chemical change like reaction between iron and sulfur, making bricks. Now write third example of chemical change from your observation. Let's recap what we have done today. We have learned reversible reactions, that what they are. We have understood reversible reactions from examples of heating copper sulfate crystals and heating nitrogen dioxide gas. We have observed chemical changes, that what happens during chemical change. We have understood chemical changes from examples like making bricks and reaction between iron and sulfur. We have also learned exothermic reactions and endothermic reactions. I have discussed exercise question related to the topic as well. I hope, students, you have understood today's topic. Now read pages 107, 108 and 109 from your book. Go through the lecture again and make some other questions also. Thank you.